Hello students, welcome in the world of biology with English sir. In this lecture we'll be studying more about molecular sieves or restriction enzymes. In our previous video we have seen restriction enzymes, how they were discovered. In this lecture we'll see the recognition sequences, naming and types of restriction enzymes. We know that restriction enzymes are the enzymes that cut the specific DNA sequences. There are three types of restriction enzymes. We have type 1 that cut around 1000 base pairs away from the recognition site. The same enzyme has endonuclease and methylase activity. Examples are ECO-K1, ECO-A1 and so on. Type 2 restriction enzymes are the enzymes that cut within the recognition sequence. Now this is very important. Only type 2 sequences are the enzymes that cut within the recognition sequence. Now endonuclease and methylase activity are on the separate entities in the protein. And in type 3 restriction enzymes, the enzyme cut 24 to 26 base pairs away from the recognition site. And again, endonuclease and methylase activity present on the same molecule. Now, by seeing this chart, it's very clear that only type 2 can cut the DNA within the recognition sequence, and that's why mostly type 2 enzymes are used. Now, HAE3 is the restriction enzyme that cuts DNA molecule at a specific sequence, which is called as a restriction site, and it has a restriction site of 4 nitrogen bases. Now see this, GGCC. Now once this site has been found by this enzyme, the cut it made at a specific nucleotide. Now that's how the cut is produced at the same nucleotide on both strand, so that there is no overhang, and thus the end produced are called as blunt ends. Now, on the basis of the cut made on the strand, the restriction enzyme can produce either blunt end or sticky end. Now this is the example of sticky end. See the ECO-RI enzyme, it recognizes the restriction sequence GAATTC. Now it makes a cut across GAAT. So it will search for the recognition sequence and it will make the cut as shown in the third figure. Now here you can see the specific overhangs are produced, and the ends, the restriction enzymes which produces these overhangs are called as sticky ends. Now in this image you can see what is the blunt end and sticky end. Blunt end means we don't have any overhang present over there. No free nitrogen bases are present. In sticky end, the cut is made at different nucleotides on both strands so that few nucleotides remained unpaired. They remained as overhang. That's why they are called as sticky end. Now mind you, these sticky ends can re-ligate. How the names of restriction enzymes are given? Restriction enzyme will have the name of a genus of a bacteria from which it is isolated, name of a species of a bacteria, strain of a bacteria, and the number of enzyme produced from the bacteria. First letter of restriction enzyme name is always capitalized, and it is used to denote the genus name. Second two letters of a name are written in small, and they are for the specific name of the bacteria. Third one is the strain name, and last one is the Roman number which denotes the number of enzymes secreted from the bacteria. Now here we have example of ECO-R1. So E stands for Escherichia coli, E stands for Escherichia, CO stands for coli, R is the strain of a bacteria, and this I designates the letter 1 of the Roman number. Now this is few more example of the restriction enzymes and its recognition sequences. We have to always remember that the sticky ends are produced. Sticky ends will have two unpaired nitrogen bases, and when these nitrogen bases are when the sticky ends are put together, they are able to ligate themselves. So those ends can be joined with the help of ligases. So restriction enzymes acts as a scissor and ligases acts as a paste. Hope you have liked this video and this is useful for you. If you have any comment, any doubt, feel free to ask, and please subscribe my channel.